Ever since the prior CEO of the Mozilla Corporation, Mitchell Baker, left and was replaced with Laura Chambers, they've been through a massive shakeup, for better or worse. Pulling out of hosting a Mastodon instance because, frankly, no one was really using it, and do they actually need to have their own instance on Mastodon? Creating the Mozilla Privacy Preserving Attribution, an attempt to resolve some of the issues with modern advertising. But it was very, very, very poorly communicated, and when people had issues with it, the response was pretty much just as bad. And a very, very heavy push into AI. Like it or not, this is the new Mozilla. And just the other day, OMG Ubuntu dropped this article. Meet Orbit, Mozilla's AI assistant extension for Firefox. Now, I'm very thankful Joey made this article, even though this is not a new extension, because the extension actually came out 3 months ago, but no one knew and no one cared. And emphasis on that, this is an extension. It is not being shipped with Firefox. Now, is that going to be the case into the future? I have no idea, because right now, it is still in beta, it is a work in progress, so it's very limited in what it can do. Now, if you're paying just a little bit of attention, you may have noticed this orb right here on both of the articles. This is the Orbit AI Assistant extension. So let's give it a shot, shall we? Now, during the installation process, they will send you to this page during the onboarding. Try Orbit for yourself. So before I go and try out various other articles, various other videos, let's do the hand-picked examples that is supposed to be basically... This is the demonstration of Orbit. This is the best case scenario. This is the video they send you to. Now, if the orb is in a weird spot, you don't like it where it is, it can be dragged to anywhere on your screen. Also, if you click the settings cog here and then click on minimal, now it's going to appear as a little thing along the side, and you can go and click on it like that. It'll hide itself a little bit when you're interacting with it. If you want to get back to where it was before, you can open up the chat box here, go to the settings cog, and then send it back to the orb. As it currently stands, this extension has two main functions, summarizing a piece of media and then asking questions about that content. If we click on this button here, this is the summarize. So this will attempt to summarize the transcript that is available for a video in the case of an article, like say the one over here, this is on Orbit. This will then take the content of the page and summarize that. So, obviously, it will sometimes take a little bit longer to do so. When we are dealing with a video, it will only be able to go and summarize the video if there is a transcript available. But on YouTube, unless you go out of your way to get rid of it, that is something that is automatically generated. This is the summarization of the video. The Mozilla Foundation, founded 25 years ago, started as a community project to keep the internet open and accessible for all. They created Firefox after Microsoft Internet Explorer dominated the market, opening up the web once again. Now they aim to keep the internet open and accessible while addressing the challenges of the digital age, including AI and its potential risks. They plan to build trustworthy AI through their venture fund and new initiative, Mozilla AI. The goal is to create an alternative to big tech companies' AI focusing on human agency and accountability. And if you go and watch the video, that is pretty much a reasonable summarization. And the one on Wikipedia is quite a bit longer, but is also good enough, because this is basing it on the content of the page, not going out and trying to research that topic based on various other things the model has been trained on. But let's go and try it with some other content, because again, this is best case scenario. So here is an article from Pharonix. I don't know why I'm zoomed in 240%. Let's summarize that one. Put the camera there. Yeah, that's fine. So this is an article on Xorg server development hitting a decade high, basically because of a single developer who has massively contributed code. And yeah, this looks pretty much fine to me. Here is one of my videos. Let's go and summarize this. This is about bottlenecks switching to a different toolkit instead of using Electron and Vue.js like they were doing so originally. I don't see any mention of Electron in here or Vue.js or Flutter or a lot of the other toolkits that are tested throughout the process, but it does get the idea of Rust and libcosmic being the new end goal. And here is a video from Zizzerain on the PoE 2 endgame. So, yeah, that pretty much gets it as well. Now, are you gonna get, like, the main content of the video? Not really, but if you're the kind of person who's very picky about the videos they watch, like, ooh, I don't want to watch a video where I don't know exactly what the content's gonna be based on the title and the thumbnail, I can certainly see some value here in, like, you know, filtering out some videos that maybe you weren't going to be interested in anyway. Now, under the settings, we can also choose how we want the information to be output. Right now, this is set to the short sentences. Let's set it over to bullet points and do another summarization. Depending on the content, you actually might get a lot more information looking at the bullet points. Also, depending on the content, it might be a lot more readable as well. Once again, what it's saying here is pretty much what I would expect. Now, the other option is paragraphs. Let's see once again what it is going to do. That is basically the exact same as short sentences. Obviously, there are things that are going to be a bit weird, especially when doing it from a video transcript, because the video transcripts are AI generated. So it's AI generated garble into AI generated garble. So this right here is supposed to say trial of Sekima. It says trial of Sucker. Obviously, videos are kind of your worst case scenario for making this happen. Articles that are, like, well written, you're gonna get much better results. But summaries are boring. The real power in a system like this is asking it questions. Now, this is where a system like this is very, very limited compared to something like ChatGPT or anything else out there, because the questions that you can ask it are entirely based on the content of the page. For example, the person that has done all of these commits is Enrico Weigelt. If we go and say, who is Enrico Weigelt? Enrico Weigelt is an open source developer who has largely been working on the Xorg server fixes and improvements around testing and better CIBSD coverage areas. He was responsible for 63% of the Git commits to the Xorg server in 2024. What has Enrico Weigelt done outside of Xorg? All of this stuff just basically repeats the same stuff about, hey, he's done some Xorg development. However, outside of Xorg, there is no mention of any significant work by Enrico Weigelt in the provided text. This is not going to do searches around the internet to find any information. It is entirely based on the content of the current page. So in some cases, if you really just don't want to read, I guess that can be kind of useful. However, it's basically as functional as a screen reader. It's a screen reader that has some summarization, and that's pretty much it. Now, the bigger issue I have is some of the examples are just flat out fabricated. Actually, all of the examples are flat out fabricated, but even more so when it doesn't actually do anything close to what you think it's gonna do. So here is the homepage. Here is the section on focus on what matters. So there's an article here about a bunch of gifts under $500. Can you highlight all gaming products in this list under $300? Let's see what an example like this is going to do with a real world article. Here we have an article on CNET. This is titled Best Gifts Under $500 for 2025. Let's look up highlight, if I can spell correctly, all of the products less than, let's say, $400. Let's see what it's going to do. Okay, it's actually doing it for this article. I've tried it for different ones, and it has just completely failed. Now, did it get the switch on there? No. No. I was about to praise it. I was about to say it actually did a good job. But the very first thing on the list, less than $400, it missed. Also, the Skylight Calendar, the Vitamix Explorian, is the Sonos Ray on there? Yes, that one is. Is the Sony is there. The Oslo Sleep Buds are... Oh wait, no, the Vitamix is there, but the Oslo Sleep Buds are not. I think for questions like this, you do a much better job just reading the list. But the problem is because it's not checking anywhere else out on the internet, here is an article where it doesn't actually list the prices for the phones directly on the listing here. It does direct you to where you can get it, and there are some here that are listed as like an ad for things you can buy now, but the main content is not there. So let's go ask the same thing here. Highlight all of the phones on the list under, I don't know, $800. Okay. Well, it missed this one here, which is like $90. Yeah, so... Very useful tool! I love AI assistants. Honestly, I'm impressed that it got this far, because last time I tested it, it didn't even come up with numbers for these phones. Now, whether or not a system like this is good, the very first thing that you probably want to know is, okay, this is coming from Mozilla, but how are they actually handling the data? What are they doing with it? Where it is being sent? Is this safe to have open when I go to my bank? Well, here is the FAQ, so let's see what they claim. How does Orbit work? So, for the current version, we are using Mistral LLM Mistral 7B hosted within Mozilla's GCP instance. Now, prior to the extension coming out, they were saying you would be able to host things locally. As it currently stands, that is not the case, and it is only going to run with Mozilla's instance. There are plans to make it locally hostable at some point in the future, though. Now, as for Mistral 7B, this is a relatively popular model available over on Hugging Face. I'll leave it linked in the description down below if you want to go and have a look at it, mess around with it, all that fun stuff. Also, according to Mozilla, does Orbit save the content of the pages I visit or summaries generated? No, it does not. When you use Orbit, we receive a payload back that contains the content of your query, information about the model queried, such as name and version number, information about technical problems with processing the query, if any, the number of tokens required to process the query, and the model outputs in response to the query. We do not store this data beyond temporarily caching it to process your query and return the outputs to you. Orbit summaries are only available on the page you're actually on. As soon as you never get away from that page, Orbit erases the session. Now, with that, you might ask, well, if they don't collect personal data and they don't collect the content of the things that you are looking at or save the queries that you are making and the response you get, how do they train the model? Well, the answer is they actually don't. Basically, all this extension is taking existing models out there that are already yoinking your data from somewhere else on the internet and basing it off of that. Mozilla themselves aren't actually doing anything here besides hosting the model. In its current state, with the summarization and the questions being literally the only functions of the extension, and it not searching the internet for anything, I legitimately don't know what the use case of the extension is. The only thing I can think of is you don't want to watch a video that might be clickbait or read an article that might be clickbait, so you summarize the content so you can get an idea of if it's actually about the thing that you expect it to be about. That is the only thing I can think of this actually being useful for, because even asking the questions, you can't really get any additional context from what you can read. Like, if you just read the thing, You will know everything that you could possibly ask it with the questions. Now, back when the extension was first released, there was a pretty big concern with it. The extension doesn't matter, the actual software running is not Libre. Even if the training algorithm would be Libre, the training data isn't. Even if the training data would be Libre, it's impossible to train with reasonable hardware for most collectors of people. Weebase invented a programming paradigm that is impossible to compile for almost anyone, and it's quite hard to host with reasonable resources. What happened to Principle 7 of the Mozilla Manifesto? That being this one right here. Free and open source software promotes the development of the internet as a public resource. Most AI usage can't have the concrete benefits of Libre software, massively lowering the dependence on a vendor, whether it's about disagreement and choices or availability on the long term. Also, Principle 6. As of now, most AI usage can only end in more centralization. That being this here. The effectiveness of the internet as a public resource depends upon interoperability, protocols, data formats, content, innovation, and decentralized participation worldwide. There can be compromises on these principles if having a very, very strong reason, like for translations, automated subtitles, text-to-speech, because it's accessibility, and there are immense benefits there. As it currently stands, though, I legitimately could not tell you, like, the benefit of this extension. Like, I actually don't know why you'd want to even run this. I'm sure there is somebody out there that has some use case for this, but at least for me, I'm not that person, and not long after this video, I will be deleting the extension and probably never thinking of it ever again. But what do you think? Have you tried out the extension before? If you have, what do you think of it? Do you actually think there is a use case here? Do you think it could be expanded to be something actually useful? Would you like something self-hosted? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out our Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I think I've done that ending before. Yeah, I actually think I have done that one before. Yeah. Well, it is what it is.